ability to increase the zinc up, increasing uptake in low available zinc, but decreasing uptake in high available zinc, which can be harmful for the plant. Another aspect I want to talk about is AM functional diversity, where different fungi species can have different ability to affect the plant in the extent of the growth and mineral response. And the interaction between the fungi, host plant, environmental, and soil factors is also very complex. For example, in study of Hart 2015, rhizophagous irregularis and funnelliform mismosis affect the tomato fruits differently in phosphorus and copper content. Here we can see the single and combination of two fungi species result different in phosphorus content and copper content. To sum up, there's a great number of studies effect of AM on food crop. However, there's few look at several crop at the same time. Another aspect is that many studies look at mineral nutrition content of food crop in the plant tissue, but few study on the edible part. So the overall aim of my study is determine the effect of AM formation on the growth and nutrition of food crop. We object to assess the effect of AM inoculation on the growth and nutrition of crop of different functional groups such as nitrogen fixing, non-nitrogen fixing, C4 and C3 plants, as well as vegetables and legumes. We object to determine the effects of soil mineral nutrition concentration on the formation of AM on the crop growth and nutrition response. Explore the effect of the growth and nutrition of crop inoculation with different AMF species. And lastly, we examine the effect of AMF inoculation on the crop productivity as well as nutrition content of edible parts. So material and methods. My studies including four experiments. In experiment one, I want to determine the impact of AM inoculation on the growth and nutrition of a range of crop species. I hypothesis that the formation of AM will have no impact on the growth and nutrition response of food crops, and crop from different functional groups have no difference in their response to AM. So in this experiment, I studied five cereal crops, five and fixing crops, five vegetative crops with and without irregularis inoculation. After 7 weeks grow them in greenhouse, I analyzed AM colonization, the growth and nutrition response of the plants. In order to do that, I analyzed the germination rate and the developing the time each crop needs to grow to ready for transplantation for the experiment. So these are some pictures, some photos of the plant with, ready for transplantation. After 7 weeks, our plant grows like this. And this is the result. So AM colonization happened in all 15 crops, and there's no colonization in the non-inoculation control. And the inoculation is different between plant species. And generally, cereals have lowest colonization, while vegetative and fixing have higher. and leeks have most significantly colonized by irregularis with higher with 80%. Here is some pictures of my plants after 7 weeks growing. In the left hand is non-AM plants, and in the right hand is AM plants. We can see some significant difference. After harvest, we measure the right way of shoot, root, and edible part of the plants, and compare the non-AM plants with the AM plants of the same crops. This is a quite complicated complicated pattern, so we convert them into mycorrhizal biomass response using this equation. And we can see here there are corn and sorghum and leek is significantly positively respond to AM formation, while others have neutral respond to AM formation. I got another set of data of mineral nutrition response for AM formation. However, I haven't got it yet. So temporary, I conclude that mycorrhizal colonization of root different between plant species, and there's no clustering between within the functional group apparently. Positive and neutral mycorrhizal biomass response were observed, and the consistent pattern found within the functional group, such as C4 and C3 and C4 cereals, as well as a nitrogen fixer, but except for vegetables. The nutritional response may show the different respond to the growth response. However, I haven't got that data yet. Future experiments. In future, I'm going to do three more experiments. Next experiment, I'm going to examine the effect of different zinc concentration on the formation of AM and the response of the crop in terms of growth and nutrition response. So I'm going to study on two crops, with and without inoculation of irregularis, and find different concentration of zinc ranging from deficiencies to toxic. And I'm going to deal with arboretum soil mixed with sand and study the mineral nutrition in the edible part of the plant. Next experiment, I'm going to study the effect of biodiversity on the growth and nutrition response of plants. So I'm going to study 5 different fungi, which is known that behave differently affect differently on the plant growth and nutrition uptake. So I'm also study on analyze the colonization, the growth and nutrition response of these fungi on plants. Before I doing this, I already did a primary experiment where I study the colonization of 5 different fungi species with and without inoculation tools to analyze the effect of biodiversity on colonization of flowers. Experiment 4. So in this experiment, I'm going to start concentrate on the productivity and the nutrition response of food crop. So I'm going to grow them to mature to harvest, to have the yield and nutrition response of edible part. So in this project, we hope to improve the knowledge of response of crop from different functional groups to AM formation in terms of growth and nutrition. We also want to link the potential of AMF to crop productivity and nutrition values of the food product. This is my initial time plan. Now I'm in the process of waiting for the last data set of nutrition response, and then next I'm going to writing a manuscript. Experiment 2 and experiment 3 will conduct it in 2018 and 2019, and the thesis will be submitted in 2020. I want to send my acknowledgement to the Vietnamese government and Adelaide University for the scholarship. Thank you very much for my, thank you very much to my supervisors, team and staff. Thank you the School of Agriculture and Food and Wine. Thank you my postgraduate Chris, helping me to overcome the difficulties in my candidate. Thank you to all members of Cab Lab, as well as another friends in the school, helping me to adapt with the new environment and doing my experiment well. Thank you to my friends and families. Thank you very much.
Great, thank you. Are there any questions for Vin? Yes.
Can you move to the hypothesis? What do you mean by forming AM, and why the formation of AM will have no impact on the growth and nutrition of plants?
Forming AMs, as I introduced before, AM is a mature association between the plant and fungi, and when we inoculate the fungi with the plant and the two come forming AM from that, the plant can benefit so from the association by receive mineral nutrition from chamber from the fungi, and fungi get the carbon supply from the plant. So forming AM means that. And in this hypothesis, I use no hypothesis that I negatively so that there's no effect, but actually, I hope they have a
fight.
Yeah, thank you.
Yes, Bina, I've got a question. You've got 15 species that you looked at in the first experiment. How are you going to select the species that you're going to use for the future experiment? And will they be different species in experiment 2, 3, and 4?
Yes, it's a very interesting question. I am to study the effect of AM formation on the growth and nutrition response of edible pulp. So I'm looking for the plant which have positive response to AM formation, as well as I can study the edible part of the plant. Mm-hmm. So in this, from experiment one, I'm considering three crops, including lettuce, carrots, and leek for future experiments. And I'm waiting for the response of the data set of nutrition response to determine which crop is going to for future experiment. Mm-hmm. And after experiment two, if there's no problem, I will continue to use two same crops for further mm-hmm. experiment.
Just one more question about you talk about nutrition response.
Yes.
But what exactly do you mean by that?
Yeah, I have to make it clear that I mean the mineral nutrition in the food products such as zinc, ions, and like the in carrot I may use vitamin A, like beta carotene for
mm-hmm.
Hidden, which is then is the